I want to call the special meeting of the Parks and Recreation Commission on Tuesday, September 17th to order.
Sorry.
It's okay. And roll call, please.
Chair Benson?
Present.
Vice Chair Graham?
She's absent for now, but will be coming in.
Commissioner Bozo?
Yes, here.
Commissioner Davis? Commissioner Rivers?
Okay, and we want to do the flag salute. And Luis, would you like to lead the flag salute, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, and Secretary's report.
What I have is the meeting agenda was posted on Friday, September 13th, 2024.
Thank you. And I need to get a approval of the agenda for today. And anyone want to make it? Sam?
Second.
Okay, first was Sam, second was Doc. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion passes. Okay. Here. And public comment on any items not on the agenda. Don't see anyone forthcoming, so we'll go to the next item. Item 7, which is the presentation by Heba Elgunde, our Public Works Director, on the city's applications for active transportation ATP grant funds for the following projects: development of the city's bicycle and pedestrian action plan and multimodal improvements on Monterey Road within the city limits.
Good evening, Commission member. It's my explanation. Thankfully, Chair Benson provided us with letters of support when we submitted the grant applications. We are bringing the item forward to the Commission's attention now, and we will have a discussion and respond to any questions that you may have. And I will be sharing the meeting minutes with MTC. We brought the same item to the Planning Commission meeting earlier this month. So we did submit two applications to the Active Transportation Program. The ATP objectives are to increase active transportation, to improve safety and mobility, reduce greenhouse gas emissions, improve public health, and provide benefits to the disadvantaged communities. These objectives are consistent with multiple regional plans, including the MTC in Bay Area 2050 and the VTA Bicycle Technical Guidelines that was last updated in 2022. As I mentioned, we submitted two grant applications. One is for developing a bicycle and pedestrian action plan. And the grant request is for $816,907. The second application is for multimodal improvements on Monterey Road within the city's boundaries. And the ask is for $21,951,000. We did not offer a local match because there wasn't any financial allocation, and it was not required for this grant program. I should mention that we already have a trails master plan, as you know, that was last prepared and approved back in 2005. Such plans are supposed to be updated every 5 years or so. So it's outdated and it does not cover the roadway network in full. It's mostly focused on trails. We also have a couple of projects in the council approved 5-year capital improvement program. One to develop a bicycle master plan and one to develop a pedestrian master plan. In the grant application, we've decided to take a different approach rather than developing a master plan. We decided to go with an action plan so that it would identify specific recommendations with an implementation plan and funding sources. And we also took the approach of combining the request to develop a bicycle and pedestrian action plan. So the plan's objective is to prepare a bicycle and pedestrian action plan that incorporates bicycle, pedestrian, and American with disabilities ADA considerations, first last mile transit connectivity, and an assessment of the city's infrastructure and non-infrastructure needs. Infrastructure refers to physical improvements to the roadways, roadway segments and intersections, while non-infrastructure could be educational initiatives and information. We have a significant portion of the city that lies within designated disadvantaged communities. And it's important to establish a pedestrian and bicycle network that serve everyone's needs, not just car drivers, regardless of economic conditions, physical abilities. Include a comprehensive public engagement program, including the establishment of a technical advisory committee, citizen advisory committee, various meetings with stakeholders, workshops, as well as information that's posted and updated regularly on website, our website, and various social media outlets. The plan would include the existing conditions analysis of bicycle and pedestrian facilities, collision statistics, and especially collisions that are covered fatalities and severe injury collisions. Equity data analysis, destinations mapping, and literature review. It will also identify the recommendations on the infrastructure and non-infrastructure sites. The draft and final plan reports will recommend the bicycle and pedestrian facilities and non-infrastructure programs. It will prioritize these recommendations, identify the financial needs and potential funding sources, and create an implementation plan of these improvements. The second grant application for Monterey Road is a larger application for almost $22 million because it covers 4.4 miles of this arterial corridor from the city boundary on the north side to the city boundary on the south side. And what I'm showing on this slide is a heat map of collisions. And the source of this heat map is the countywide local roads safety plan. TGKM was the consultant that prepared this regional plan for the county. And they analyzed the safety conditions within the different jurisdictions. But not to the same extent as individual local road safety plans. And I should share with you also that a little bit of good news. Last week, we were notified that we're getting 190,000 in SS4A grant that we applied for a few months back. That's Safe Streets for All grant. For developing local road safety plan for the city of Gilroy. So it will be much more comprehensive than what the information that's included in the county plan. Why selecting Monterey Road? Because it's a regional corridor. It connects Gilroy to San Martin, to Morgan Hill, through San Jose. And it's also identified as a priority safety corridor in the city of San Jose. It's designated in the city's general plan as a bike route, although we don't have bicycle facilities throughout the corridor. And there is a significant presence of deficiencies on the bicycle and pedestrian infrastructure. As I mentioned, we covered the corridor for the whole length within the city's boundary, within the city's limits. Beyond that, it's county, and beyond that is Caltrans, where it connects with US. Plan sheet is from our general plan. It identified the different bicycle facilities along Monterey Road. It's for the majority of the lanes, it's class two bike lanes. Although we're now, when we submitted the application, we mostly requested for buffered bike lanes, not physically separated, not protected bicycle lanes. It's class two still, but buffered with pavement marking to separate it from the auto travel lanes. But there are no physical devices in the buffer. In the downtown area, it would continue to be class three shared. I will not go through all of the plan sheets. I didn't include all of them. But we evaluated all 4.4 miles in terms of deficiencies of bicycle and pedestrian facilities and identified the segments that we would need to be improved. The red line here identifies the new sidewalks, and the blue lines are for the class two buffered bike lanes. I should mention that bike lanes typically start and end at intersections. So it wouldn't start or end at a mid-block location. So if there is a section here that's missing, that's because as we have the existing facilities and we're only highlighting the deficient parts. So we did a similar practice throughout the corridor. And I should also mention that for some segments, not the whole, because of the cost, it is quite significant as it is as an application. But for some segments, we also recommended street lighting. And we recommended at this location at 9th Street to have a hop signal. That's the pedestrian activated signal for to accommodate the pedestrian and bicycle crossings. This actually hop signal is already funded to the north side of Chester. It's currently in design. It was previously designed, but we're making improvements to it because there is a section that's missing sidewalk here. So we added it to the scope. We received two grants for this hub, each for 350,000, covering design and construction. So we added this section of the missing sidewalks. That's why it's not highlighted as a deficiency. And this would be the location of the hub near the senior house.
And that's what my question was going to be later. Thank you.
And it goes all the way. I did not include the exhibits for the four tents, but it goes all the way to the city's boundaries as it connects to the Caltrans right of way near US. These are the cross sections, and it varies depending on the pavement widths available to us in the right of way. It could include just buffered bike lane, or in the downtown area, it's shadows, as you know, and it will continue to be shadows, with, in some cases, angle bar parking, and in other segments, it's parallel parking. But for the majority of the lands, what we're asking for is to establish buffered bike lanes.
So, but just to clarify, buffer, do you mean separated, the ones that are painted, the green paint kind of bike lanes?
Yes, buffered, the pavement marking, it could be 2 feet. Actually, for the vehicle code, the separation is supposed to be 3 feet. But the marking itself, depending on the availability of the width, we went down to 2 feet. It's just pavement marking separating the bike lane from the auto travel lane.
Mm-hmm.
A class four is when we have physical devices within this painted area,
right.
Like delineators or curb lines or other physical.
Right. And the ghosting one is just the markings on the street that just show that the bike.
Okay. For a number of reasons, the cost, when we added up all the estimates, two, we don't have the maintenance equipment to presently maintain a class four. These require 5 foot sweepers, for example, equipment we don't have, and would not be the priority to purchase currently. So we're going with class, which could be upgraded in the future.
And are we making any changes to parking, or are we keeping the parking as is through downtown?
In the downtown area, no, we did not. And the parking in the downtown area is very valuable to the businesses within mm-hmm. downtown. So we didn't want to impact the abutting land uses.
Okay, thank you.
With that, I conclude my presentation, and we'd be happy to answer any questions you may have or yes.
I have one question. On the Monterey and 10th Street intersection, where we have kids, 10th Street or is it just where they're coming from school? Coming from the high school, 10th Street. And
yes,
10th
yes.
Street. Yes. It seems unsafe there when we were always talking about maybe some kind of a flyover for the, you know, pedestrians, but I don't see that. But you know, I was wondering the future, a safe route for the kids walking from the schools across
the railroad track area?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Track area. So
yes.
I know we talked about that here.
It's what I can share with you is not part of the grant application.
Okay.
The 10th Street in Monterey is signalized intersection.
Right.
And that's the extent of the traffic control device that you would have.
Okay.
For. What we will be pursuing, because as you know, the station will serve high speed rail in the future. What's being considered now is ad grade all along the section within Gilroy. We will be pursuing grant applications to evaluate the grade separation, not necessarily at the station itself, because they're planning six tracks within the station to serve Caltrain service, UPRR, and the high-speed rail. But we have two other crossings within Gilroy. The city of Morgan Hill, for example, they received an earmark to do this evaluation, and we will be pursuing a similar initiative.
Thank you.
So, how about you mentioned that we, as part of the city, we did approve under the capital improvement program to do a bicycle and ped action plan.
Yes, but they're not funded.
Okay, I thought. Okay, so it's an unfunded capital improvement. Okay, got you.
As you can see here at the top,
I can't see that.
It's unfunded.
Okay.
They are identified as need.
But they're unfunded.
And council approved the CIP, including these two needed master plans. But there is no budget associated
with it. Gotcha.
And so this grant will make these happen. It's a joint plan.
Yes.
Great.
That's my question. Okay.
With the $21 million multimodal grant, that's including improvements, right? $21 million, including improvements.
Yes.
Great. That's fantastic.
Now I have a slide here that shows that would be for the actual construction. It doesn't cover everything, of course. Like we didn't include amenities or street furniture. We covered street lighting in some segments, but we focused on the infrastructure improvements, like the basics, and we can build on that, which is the bicycle facilities and the sidewalks.
Yeah, that's great. That's great. Okay.
So these are applications that we're submitting. Time frame, possibility of these passing, any idea?
Well, this particular application is actually considered on multiple levels. We will find out if we would get on the state level, I believe in November. But we're not offering any local match, and we're competing heavily with jurisdictions throughout the state, and with the deficiency that the state has now in the budget, the shortfall, they reduced the funding available for some grant programs. But this grant program now only have 850 million, I believe, for the state. So it went down significantly. But we still need it to pursue it. And even if they would award a partial fund, then we would segment and phase the project. And in the application itself, we said we would be willing to take less money, right? And there is also a second round of consideration on the regional level. And we would find out about that in January of next year.
I have a question, So funds are limited and you have this plan. Let's say it goes out 5 years. Do you have to keep updating the plan or making compensation for new growth or anything like that? How does time is not on our side in terms of waiting for money? And so how is
that it's important to develop the plan itself because it will identify all the improvements and it will help us in pursuing other grant programs. Like we're quite happy, despite that it's a relatively small grant that we applied for. It's only 190,000 for the local road safety plan that we got awarded last week. But it will allow us to apply for the HSIP grant program, the Highway Safety Improvement Program.
Okay.
So having the plans in itself give us a better opportunity to apply for other grant programs.
That makes sense.
And although this is just a planning document, it will recommend all the improvements that we need citywide.
Yeah.
Then we can tackle them, whether individually or on area-wide basis.
Okay, so it's that comprehensive.
Yeah.
Yes.
Before you got here, she said it hadn't been approved. I mean, it hadn't been updated since 2005. So these being 20 years old, by the time we get to it, it has to be done, and this will help us in all ways, getting more funding for other things. And that's sort of why we want the Park Master Plan as well. So, yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
And the 2005 document, it's mainly covering trails.
Right.
This document would cover trails as well as the roadway network.
Okay.
And I should have mentioned that these two applications are under different programs within the programs. Like this is a planning document, while this is an infrastructure project that will help us build improvements. So they are under different categories of the grant program.
Thank you for making that clear. Okay, so anyone else have any questions? Okay, so now we kind of close this part of it, and we're looking for a recommendation, yes? And that would be on to City Council for approval, correct?
I would like to at least mention that there is support.
Yes. Oh, go ahead, yes. Go right ahead. Whatever you want.
I would like your feedback, because this will all be shared in the minutes.
So personally, I'm very much in favor of something like this. I mean, downtown Monterey for a bike is dangerous. As a cyclist myself, I very rarely go down because it's just too hard to deal with the traffic. So this would be a big improvement all along Monterey Highway. So I'm very strongly in favor of it.
I'm in favor of it, both plans. Definitely we need the planning document to move forward. And number two, for the infrastructure, it's huge. I hope you get everything you're asking for. So I'm totally for this project.
I am too. I think it positions yourself for whatever availability of monies and whatnot are there. You've already got the plan and it's vetted, so you can move on a better way, which is what you need. Yeah.
Either one of you commenting?
No, I'm totally in favor of it, because that senior building, that's that Monterey Oaks. Is
yeah.
That's what it's called?
Yeah, I think so.
Now, from the beginning, it had no sidewalks.
Mm-hmm.
Seniors were moving in, and it was not a safe place. So we're going to make this a safe place.
Yeah.
And I'm totally in favor of that. Yeah.
Thank you. Actually, this element will come sooner. Because we've already received the two grants, or the total is 700,000.
Mm-hmm.
We're almost done with the design. Then we will proceed with the construction. So hopefully by mid next year it will be.
That's great.
Nice.
Great. Okay. So now.
Yes, I believe you have a question.
Okay.
Well, is there another senior facility being planned for Monterey Road? No, that you know of?
Not as far as
just that one. Okay.
Not on Monterey, anyway. Isn't there another one on? Well, we don't know. But we'll see the results of that one.
Yeah.
That has a big deal to go through anyway.
I have a question, because I'm so sorry, I misread. So when you're talking about the senior center place on Monterey, you're talking about the big high-rise building right there that just kind of stands alone?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
There's no bus stop signs there, are there? There's other
there
not,
are actually nearby are
there?
Bus stops.
Nearby, but
there
not...
No...
Yeah, if it's a senior area, it's not like you can walk out and there's the... Yeah.
Yes.
And who decides where that bus stop
VTA does,
VTA.
Because of the spacing between the bus stops. With that being said, we are represent the city on a number of committees with VTA, and we correspond with them on a regular basis. So once we have a controlled crossing like this in place, we would coordinate with them and request that the bus stops would be shifted closer, but they wouldn't necessarily be in favor of relocating the bus stops without a safe crossing.
Right. Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyone else? If not, we'll move forward and do the.
Can we move?
Yes, that's for better. So, our action, I believe, is to make a recommendation for approval to the city council. Correct.
We are not taking the applications to city council.
Okay.
If we get awarded, then we will go for city council.
Okay, so you just want a voice vote on our approval, basically?
Yes,
okay.
On your support.
Okay.
It will be reflected in the minutes, and I will share it with
okay.
MTC.
All right. So I'd like to have a motion reflecting our support of this project for the two grants so she can pursue. And so I will need a first and a second.
So moved.
Okay, Sam. And second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor of support of this project for the grants to be applied for, say yes.
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 Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Thank you very much.
Approved.
Appreciate it.
Unanimously. Okay. All right. All right. Now, we can adjourn the meeting at 6:51 p.m.
Wow.
Yes.
How about that?
Six 6:51.
That's a record.
Well,